Yeah, it's okay. Do right, left, forehand, backhand.
Okay.
Okay, focus on the recovery with crossover step. Go. Can you stay behind the service line? Can you do exactly the same and close your eyes?
Yeah. It's hard to split step in the middle.
You don't have to see. Just count the steps. It's hard, I understand, when you close your eyes. But the reason to do all this exercise is for you to count how many steps you need from a center to go quarterly, to go fully to the corner.
Mm-hmm.
And when you do that, when you go back, you know exactly how many steps you get back.
Yeah.
So you do it so many times, so you do it more efficiently. Okay.
Yes.
So do it four times. Forehand, backhand, forehand, backhand. Count the steps.
Okay.
Maybe count split step. 1, 2, and swing.
So are we going all the way over there?
Okay, what did I say? How many steps?
2.
How?
Split step, 1, 2, step.
Okay. Okay, so do it for how many times?
4.
4, okay, show me. Regular, open your eyes, regular. That was 4 steps.
Mm-hmm.
Yes or no?
Yes.
Okay, show me 2 steps. 1, 2. 1, 2. 1, 2. 1, 2. Do you understand?
Yes.
Do exactly the same with closed eyes. Relax. This is very, very good what you did. You did identically close eyes or open eyes. I don't think you ever done that before. You done it before?
No.
Okay. When you close your eyes, what do you think?
Split step, right, left, hit. Split step, right, left, hit.
Okay. So this is more to yourself, right? Which is nothing wrong with it. You're focusing on that part.
Yeah.
So I think, and I'm confident you understood how to do that.
Yes.
Okay? I want you to do one more time with closed eyes, and I want you to picture a scenario that you picture the opponent on the other side. You picture, like, you know, where to hit the ball. Cross court, down the line. You play high ball. Do you understand?
Yes.
Let me see. Okay. My question to you after that was good. Okay. Did you swing every ball the same or you change?
The first 3 I hit normally.
What's normally?
Like, a medium speed.
Medium speed, like what percentage?
If like that takes 60.
60?
Yeah.
Okay, and then the fourth one?
Like 75.
Okay. Can you do it one more time And you don't have to tell me which swing was slow or fast. Okay? I want to see difference of the acceleration. Close your eyes, okay? Okay. What do you do?
The first one, I swing 80%, then 60%.
How much?
60.
60, okay.
And then I hit 80.
I saw that. I respect that. Okay. Did you think like that kind of pattern, or just happened to be?
I thought.
You thought, okay, so what's your end result? Why you did that?
So first I hit it deep to the corner to the opponent, so he gives me a high one. I gave him a short angle, he gave me one. I hit a really hard one.
And where do you hit the hard one?
What?
Where do you hit the hard one?
Cross court.
Okay.
And then he hit it back, and then I hit a cross court, and he went with an angle.
So you play only cross court?
Yes.
Fair enough. Again, it's nothing right or wrong. You can tell me down the line. I'm okay with that. It's for you to have some clarity what to do.
Yes.
Can you do the same exercise in your room?
Yes.
How?
You find the room that has space.
Not in your room.
No.
You cannot do it in your room.
No, mine's too small.
Even better, why?
What?
Why? How much room do you need?
Like this much?
That's max. You just close your eyes. You don't have to get swing the racket. Just have your racket in your hand. Picture it. Take your grip. You do this. You do this. You do the volley, you do drop shots. Do you understand?
Yes.
That's the next level. Mm-hmm. That's called visualization.
Yes.
Just go in a quiet place or a very loud place, okay? Because sometimes you get distracted when the weird noises. When you have people playing next door, next court, they make sounds, they're screaming, you get distracted. Yes or no?
Yes.
Everybody gets distracted in your age, pretty much, even the older kids. So try to condition yourself how to eliminate any distraction.
Yes.
Sometimes when the place is very, very quiet and silent, you don't know how to deal with that.
Yes.
It happens. So find your own space that you feel comfortable when you're not comfortable.
Yes.
Do you understand?
Yes.
Okay. Can you do it one more time?
Yes.
Let's practice the either standing, okay, and then closing your eyes and have your racket and try to maneuver it.
So okay. Like this? Like yeah. That?
What do you think about it?
So first I did a forehand cross court, and then a backhand down the line, and then I did a forehand cross court, and then a backhand cross court.
Okay, fair enough. So I'm trying to give you some ideas how to practice tactics you're going to use. So if you practice every day for a little bit, 5 minutes, 3 minutes here and there, when you come to the court, it's easier to execute it.
Yes.
That's what I'm trying to tell you.
Yes.
Do you understand?
Yes.
Don't always expect to have a tennis court to practice this mindset part.
Yes.
It's going to help you a lot to have more clarity on your tactic, what to do. Understand?
Yes.
Again, I didn't tell you where to hit the ball, what to do with it. You create your identity. You build on that. There's nothing right or wrong or shaft selection. You decide to go cross court, you decide to go down the line, okay, go for it. but you have to be accountable for it. If you miss it, you can say, okay, I'm going to do next time better movement with my footwork.
Yes.
I'm going to get more under the ball so it doesn't hit the tape of the net.
Yes.
If you make the shot, okay, that's great. Keep doing it. Keep doing it.
Yes.
Got it?
Yes.
Okay. I want to continue and do a few exercises with the bends. I love it. Okay, we did like the forehand and the backhand.
Yeah.
We didn't do the serve.
Yes.
Okay, serve is great, right?
Mm-hmm.
Is your best part of the game? Yes?
I don't know.
Okay. You should be confident. Like, yeah, it's my best part of my game, or it's more the least part of my game favorite. Because X, Y is a reason. Okay?
Yes.
So I want you to get a little more consistent posture and stronger the arm. Okay? Before we start, get quick water. You need it. That's good. So this part, the visualization we just practice, is the most important part and powerful part for the young kids, because it's training them to have the muscle memory physically for the arms, for the legs, and also the muscle memory for the brain, that they have to do something on their own pace. Nobody's telling them how fast to move, nobody's telling them where to hit the shot, they visualize. And on their own, they can practice like at the match point, they can practice how they feel under pressure. So they build, you know, that, they try to improve it. And that's the best way to improve any kind of healthy discomfort on their own kind of fear. Because everybody has kind of weakness and strengths, but they don't want to face their weakness loudly. And so on their own pace, give them the room to do it. It's very, very powerful what they can do with their mind. I strongly recommend it. You good?
Yeah.
Let's go on that side. Do you have a second racket, Alex?
Yeah.
Bring it.
We didn't take it. Oh, that's a
problem. No, we don't have it.
No.
I didn't take mine. We have to. We don't have another
one. It's okay. Are you mine? It's okay, it's different. Warm up your serve, let's go. Okay.
With the ball?
So, before we start, last time we used this tool with Alex to improve the... Do you remember what we did?
Ray position and take back.
Loudly.
Ray position and take back.
Slower and louder.
Ready position and take back.
Take back of what?
Of forehand and backhand.
Okay, very good. Okay, today we're gonna focus on the serve. How to use this rubber band to improve the serve.
Yes.
Okay, first we're gonna warm up the serve. I'm gonna allow Alex to do 10 or 12 serves to warm up the shoulder, the toss, and then I'm gonna ask him if he's ready, and then we're gonna move on. Okay, go to the other side. Why you start from the other side first?
I don't know.
You don't know?
No.
Okay. The other side is my favorite side. What's your favorite side?
The other side.
Why?
Cause it's all the important points on mostly.
Thumbs up. Two thumbs up. Wow. Okay, why the most important point?
Because it's where you're not even, you're different, like 40-15 or
40-15?
No, that's a 30-15.
Okay.
Is on here. 15 love is on here.
You make it too hard to yourself.
Yes.
Yes. Okay.
Yes.
when you have break point or game point,
yeah,
you're serving.
Yeah.
You're 40-30.
Yeah.
You win the game. 40 love is a game point.
Yes.
The opponent has a break point. You're 30. He's 40. You have to save yourself.
Yes.
You understand? Sometimes you play matches with no ad, and they decide to receive on the ad side.
Mm-hmm.
It's almost a break point for the guy, or you have a game point.
Mm-hmm.
So when you have to win the game or to defend yourself, not to lose the game, the ad side has a little bit more weight on it. It's more powerful.
Yes.
Okay. If you know how to serve from the ad side well and win those games, it's easier.
Yes.
Okay. That's why I like to start off always from the ad side.
Yes.
Okay?
Okay.
Let's go. Warm up. What's your song?
I have no idea.
Okay. Yes, the first one. What took so long? Yes. Be mindful what you're doing, okay? Just easy, second service in. Are you doing spin or flat? It's not a tricky question. I don't want you to take too long to answer.
Spin?
Why spin?
Because it's more consistent.
But you're warming up.
Flat.
Why flat?
Because you're more like, it's easier to get the ball in.
Why it's easier?
Because you're hitting flat, you're not putting spin that makes it go in the net.
Okay. The biggest part is if you're warming up, your wrist, your shoulder is not fully warmed up, right?
Yes.
If you try to spin it, you have to pronate more.
Yeah.
You have to use more shoulder.
Yes.
But if you put flat or serve, it's just like a straightforward motion.
Yeah.
So less impact on the joints. That's why we start with flat serve. And it's easier to make it over the net. Got it?
Yes.
Go. So now give me a flat serves. That was flat or spin?
Probably in the middle.
It's not in the middle, it's flat or spin?
Spin.
Okay, give me a flat serve. Okay, that's a little flatter. I'm going to challenge you. Put it here, there's just one. Okay. Front leg here.
Okay.
Okay. You don't have to get your foot off this ring. It stays there. Okay?
Okay.
Let's see if you can do it. Are you doing flat or spin?
Flat.
Okay. If it's flat, watch me. You're scratching too much. Okay. Forward, more forward.
Okay.
less sound. That was flat?
No.
No?
No.
Okay. Here. Flat?
Yeah.
Okay. Hit the frame. If it was flat, go up your racket. Up your racket. Is that correct grip?
Yeah.
Okay, good. Flat is here.
Mm-hmm.
Going here a lot.
Mm-hmm.
That's not flat. This. See how that works?
Yeah.
The palm face the net. Now, open your palm. What's the grip? This is the grip, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yes?
Yes.
Is here, right? Mm-hmm. Do you agree?
Yes.
Open the palm. Open. Stop there. Stop there. Hold it. The palm face exactly to the center of the box. So if you know how to use your palm, you can use the spin or the flat or the kick serve.
Yeah.
Do you understand?
Yeah.
Stay there, stay there, stay there. This is the palm, right? I put your racket back. Is it right grip?
Yes.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Okay. Slice. Yes?
Yes.
Open your fingers, open. So now, this palm points to the dew side.
Yes.
Do you understand?
Yes.
So open your fingers. Here, points to your left. Flat, more to the center.
Yes.
Okay. Here, more to the right is kick serve, because you're gonna drop and do this. See how it works?
Yes.
Now, since you understand that part, we're gonna work it out with a bend.
Okay.
Let's see how you're gonna try to strength. We'll try to and strength now these small ligaments here in the joint of the wrist, and hopefully the muscle is gonna be working how to use it.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? For the muscle memory. Hold it. Put your racket in the basket. Actually, you can use your racket because my grip is too big. Okay, give it to me. What do you sing?
I have no idea.
You say something. What's your favorite song?
I don't have one.
I want to make one. Do you like classical music?
I don't know the difference of the songs.
Oh, okay, fine. Okay.
So this way?
So, relax. I didn't say anything. Relax. What you sing?
I don't know what I'm singing.
Okay, that's
no
fine.
Idea.
Okay. Zero. Sorry. Yes. Okay. Stay there. Stay there. I'm pulling. I'm pulling you. Make sure the grip is correct. Good. Good. Do you feel it?
Yeah.
Yeah? Be strong. Good job. Close your eyes. Visualize now where you're serving. Visualize you're gonna bend your knees. Visualize you're gonna have a nice kick serve or flat serve or ace, and you're gonna celebrate after. Yeah? Don't get distracted. Don't get distracted. Be strong with your posture. Relax. Wow. That was hard?
At the end, yes.
Oh, of course. I tried to adjust it. Okay? How's your wrist?
Good.
Good. Okay, now you're gonna take your racket back, bring it down to your back. Okay, so from zero, you're gonna go back to one. I show you, zero.
Zero, two,
zero,
one.
Zero, zero,
zero.
This is one, right? Yeah? Left arm stays up, left arm up. Left arm up. Now going over, stop there. Okay. Okay, hold on, this is the problem I have here. You're sticking your belly out. Oh yeah. Oh yeah, nice. Okay. Hold on. I don't want you to rest, I want you to... Okay, hold on, relax, relax. Hold your racket properly. Okay, I don't pull you at all. I don't do anything with the bands. Okay, I feel you're very tight over here. I want you to relax a little bit. Keep my space back. Okay. Your belly, yep. Hold your racket properly. You good? Come on. This is details right now for your posture, okay? Okay. Follow me. I want space. That's good. Okay. This way we want. We want to have... Can I take the beanie off? You don't need it. Thanks. I want gap. Like this. I don't want the racket to be too close. I want to see gap. Okay? And I want to see the elbow to point up to the sky. Follow me. Follow me. Follow me. Don't squeeze. Follow. It's okay. Trust me. I want to relax. I want this to be relaxed. Yes?
Yes.
Are you getting tired?
Yes.
Oh, yes. Good. You should be relaxed. Left arm up. Very nice. Okay. Now the fun part is going to begin. Okay? I want you going to follow me, okay? To do this. But I'm going to have the band pulling you down. So I'm going to work this muscle now. What's this muscle? Do you know it?
Biceps?
Tricep. Yes?
Yes.
Good. Stay, like stay, like stay. Stay, stay. Very good. Pull, 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 pull. Are you pulling with one finger or... There you go. Pull, pull, pull. Pull, pull, down, down, up, 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 down. Can you bend your knees? Bend your knees. Good. When you get your racket up, I want you to go up with your legs stronger. Stay. Stay, down, up, yes, down, up, faster now, go, fast, show me how fast you can be, fast, good job, relax, your pinky is coming off, do it better, okay, hold it, relax, 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 relax. You get tired?
Yeah.
Where?
This arm.
Oh, the left. Oh. So that's nothing, right? Mm-hmm. But you have to get stronger.
Yeah.
Okay. It's actually very good because it's helping your posture to be balanced. Okay? Again. Service grip. Okay. Down. Left arm. Great. Stop, stop. Stop. Where is this? Fantastic. Out. Yes, like that. Okay. Fast. Very good. Fast. Look up in the sky. Up. Down. Up. Down. 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 Yes. Up. Very good. Okay. You keep doing the same mistake. This coming off. You understand?
Yes.
Okay. I prefer this to come off than this.
Mm-hmm.
Got it?
Yes.
Stop. Yes. Good job. Up. 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 Very good. Up. All right. Now you try to serve, okay?
Okay.
Now, what we just did is not gonna be specifically helping your flat spin or kick. I'm preparing you. I want to see more power, explosivity. Okay?
Okay.
Got it. Get the ball.
Do I still do this thing?
What thing?
The circle?
Yes. This is very important for your balance. It's okay. Faster. Pretend I have the band behind of you. Go fast. You can go faster. Very good. That's very good. In your mind, faster from the 2 to 3. Very good, Alex. You can do it even faster. That was great swing. One more time. Again. When you bounce the ball, listen. Bounce the ball a little bit slower and remind yourself to go very fast the arm. That was great. That was fast. Again. Can you bend your knees a little bit?
Yes.
While your racket goes down to up. Again. Get your racket back slowly. No. Zero. Racket up. Left arm up, bend your knees. Stay there, stay there. Yes. Here and fast. Got it?
Mm-hmm. So fast, fast, fast.
Okay. You can go fast, exactly. Go. That was good. But I don't feel you bend your knees enough. Got it? Very good. Go faster your arm. Very good. Okay. Next variation. Give me your racket. Give me your racket. We're gonna try while the racket is up on the contact point to strengthen the wrist. Okay? In a certain way. Okay? Get your racket. Wait, wait, wait. Zero. It's dropping. Left arm up. Left arm up. Left arm up. He's going here. Stop. Stop. Here. Left arm up. Stay. Can you do it by yourself?
Yeah.
Go for it. I'm helping you. So this is for the slice or flat? What type of serve is this?
For the flat.
Louder.
For the flat.
Louder.
For the flat.
This is for the flat serve. Come on. Come on. Excellent. Relax. Relax. Woo. Easy or hard?
Hard.
Hard. Why is hard?
Because you're using your wrist like this.
You have something to go against, right? So, I strongly recommend you to practice that because it's going to help you when it's very windy conditions. The wind is in front of you. You have to go against the wind very strong. You have to get a very strong wrist to do that. Or it's very cold outside and the balls are very heavy, you can still have to go very hard. So in reality, we try to strengthen the wrist so you don't hurt yourself. Do you understand?
Yes.
Let's go a few more repetitions. No, 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 zero, zero, zero. Back. Bend. Stay, 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 stay. Stay up, stay. Stay, stay, stay. Fight, fight, fight. Come on. Excellent, that was great. See how you pronate a little bit?
Yeah.
Go again. Left arm. Left arm. Down, 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 down. Very good. Woo! Let's try now without the bend. Okay. This is a very good way to, for Alex to strengthen muscle memory, first of all, because we condition the forearm and the wrist to have a certain angle. One. Two, we strengthen the shoulder. So we try to get as high as we can for a long enough time, 10, 15, 20 seconds, and do like enough repetitions. And also we condition the left shoulder to stay up, so have a nice long toss. So everything has to be with the posture on the shoulders. The neck is very important, these muscles we condition. And also the back, the low back, to don't arch too much. So it's a lot of muscle contractions per se, and also a lot of mental strength, because your body doesn't want to do it, but you try to condition your brain to do it. Let's go. You have the racket. Let me see now the flatter pronation forward a little bit. That's okay. Keep your left arm longer, higher up. That was a better sound. That was true flat surf. Try again. You can go faster the arm. Keep going. Can you tell me exactly the contact point where it's supposed to be? Show me the contact point without the rope. Go forward. Forward your racket. Racket. Yes. Down. Down. Yes. Up. Down. Down your racket. Very good. Okay? Very good. Go faster. Again. Stay up with your left arm longer. You're dropping a little bit too soon. Did you see the ball with your eyes and the contact point?
No.
That means you're falling down. Yeah. Keep looking up longer. I want to see if you can stay in this position to do this. You have to see with your eyes.
Okay.
Again. That was very good. If the toss is to your left, you cannot do the flat serve.
Yeah.
Toss the ball slightly to your right, between 12 to 1. Right now is almost 12 to 11. Bring it a little more to your right. Okay? It's a little bit higher. Are you tired? Alex, are you tired?
Tiny bit.
Okay, it's fine. It's normal. Because you feel a little bit tired, make sure you slow down the first part. That was very good sound. That was so elegant, so relaxed. Do you understand?
Yes.
Okay. Let's go. Next variation. Let's see if you know how to pronate. Okay. So, hold the grip. Very good. Okay. Down your racket.
Left arm up. Up, 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 up. Stay there. Stay there. Pull me forward like this now. Go, 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 go. Up. Up to the sky.
Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Yes. Come on. All right. Hold on. Hold on. Is this now what type of serve?
Slice.
Absolutely. So we do the slice. You understand?
Yes.
That's your favorite, right? Yeah? Yeah. No? Of course. Ready.
Up, 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 up.
Go, 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 go.
Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Ah, very nice. Where do you feel it?
Right here.
So it's the lower part of your wrist or the upper part? Up?
Up. Or,
yes, because we're doing this. Try to go forward, right? Let me see.
Wow, so easy, right?
Yeah.
No way. So powerful. In your mind, pretend I have the band here.
Yeah.
Lead here. See the inside part of the racket? I want to stay as long as you can leave.
Okay.
Ready?
Okay.
One more variation, okay? Bear with me. Now we're gonna do it for the kickstroke. Okay? How to pronate.
Yes.
How do you like it? Is correct? Yes?
Yes.
Alright, I like it. Down, up, down, down. Keep up. Stay, stay, down. Yeah? Got it?
Yeah.
Up, up, up. Stop there. Hold it. So I'm going now, this part, can you see?
Uh-huh.
To turn to your right. So we're going to do right, right. Yes. It stays here now. Stop there, stop there. Now, the band is pointing to the actual box. Stop, take your breath, take your breath. That's correct, breath?
Yes.
Here. And then we turn to the right. Up to the right. Breathe. And twist to the right. Bend the elbow. Bend the right elbow. Up. Follow me, follow me. Turn. That's how we pronate. Up, right, relax. Okay? I know I helped you know that, because it's very hard to do it on your own yet. But I'm giving you the idea how to do three different serves. Flat, slice, kick. Do you understand?
Yes.
One part is the wrist, how to use it. The other part is the toss. Do you understand?
Yes.
So, right now I'm conditioning the wrist and the angle of your racket, how to use it. So let's see if you can do the pronation to the ball, okay? Can you show me how to do the pronation slowly, very slowly, without bent? Drop down, here, lead like this, pretend the bend is here, and then what happens? Yes! Lead, turn. Whoa! Sleep, turn. Wow! Okay, take a ball. That was a kick, sir. That's very cool. Easy, right?
Mm.
Sound. Can you force the rotation to the right ball?
Okay.
Higher, lock higher.
to the right of the back. So if I ask you to summarize me, tell you Sule, so you call.
So give me a summary what we just did with the band and yourself.
Strengthening the wrist and strengthening the motion of the surf.
What kind of surfs?
All three.
Can you mention to them?
The flat surf, the slice surf, and the kick surf.
Very good, excellent. Now, do you think you did very well all of the surfs?
No.
Not all of them. No. But it's a learning progress.
Yes.
Okay. So we try to progress slowly. I'm giving now the idea, I'm preparing the ground for you to be, and now that's the repetition, right? You have to go on your own and serve each type of serve 10 or 15 times.
Yes.
See if you can be consistent with the toes, see if you can be consistent with the motion, and see if you can be consistent with the accuracy.
Yes.
Okay. I'm giving now the tools how to do it. It's now is to you to understand it and to remind yourself. Okay?
Yes.
That was very good how patiently you did it with me, like for a good 25 minutes. Okay, it's not easy.
Yes.
Okay? So, slowly we're going to do a little bit more and more of that, and building on that, okay? Very good.